Hey there, and welcome to Play Noggin. I'm Julian, your brain's player too. I, like a lot of you, have always been fascinated by the idea of exploring another world. The problem right now is the length of time it takes to travel to a distant planet or solar system, and I guess the fact that the technology hasn't been developed yet. But that's never stopped me from dreaming. Ideally, I'd like to visit another world of my own free will, and not be yanked from the Earth in an instant along with a chunk of a national park. That's the inciting incident of Abduction, the latest game from the Myst creators Cyan Worlds. See, it's a play on words. Abduction is a geological process in which the edge of a tectonic plate consisting of oceanic crust is thrust over the edge of an adjacent plate consisting of continental crust. Abduction is what happened to you, and the aliens responsible used a form of technology that has been a mainstay of science fiction for years. Technology that's actually existed in real theoretical science for longer than you might think. Teleportation. Teleportation involves scanning something at a subatomic level and sending the data gathered from the scan to some distant location where a perfect copy is reconstructed. When I say copy, I mean copy. Since 1993, when quantum teleportation was first deemed a theoretical possibility, we've understood that the act of scanning an object fully destroys that object, to the point that the copy created is the only thing that remains. So, great, not only are aliens ripping me away from my home, but they're also obliterating my original body. Could they at least give me a new bod with some super speed or some buff muscles or something? I don't know, it's not too much to ask. Now, maybe the thought of having your body as you know it obliterated in the name of a convenient commute squicks at you a bit. Me too. But the question of how many of my subatomic particles need to be originals for me to be who I am isn't the point here, although it is fascinating. In 1998, researchers successfully sent a single photon approximately 1 meter along a coaxial cable, and just as everyone had theorized, the moment the photon appeared at its destination, the original ceased to exist. It didn't travel, it was copied, destroyed, and cloned. In order for quantum teleportation to be possible, scientists had to find their way around something called the Heisenberg Uncertainty Principle. Now, I looked it up, and surprisingly, it has nothing to do with blue crystal meth, and I might watch too much TV. Anyway, it's the idea that you can never know both the location and the momentum of a particle. The more we nail down data on one of these things, say a photon's location, the less we end up knowing about the other, its momentum, and vice versa. The scientists who teleported this photon succeeded by using a phenomenon called entanglement. That's the principle which allows two particles to stay connected to each other, even over great distances, so that what happens to one directly affects the other. So one photon in a lab could be spun, and its entangled photon hundreds of miles away would also start to spin. Even Albert Einstein referred to this phenomenon as spooky action at a distance, which is genius scientist speak for whoa, that is weird. To teleport a single photon, they actually needed three. One, the original, to be teleported. Two, a photon used to transport the information from the first. And three, a photon entangled with photon 2, upon which the information was written. See, if the researchers had tried to get up close and personal with photon 1 to read its information, they would have altered it, thus making it impossible to teleport in its actual state. That's because subatomic particles exist simultaneously in all states until they are observed. To interact with the particle directly would require them to observe it. Observing a particle locks it into one state, which wouldn't be representative of the actual particle. With photon 2 acting as a sort of buffer, they can copy the info onto photon 3 over a distance, thus successfully teleporting photon 1. Is your head spinning? Because my head's spinning. Now, unless we want our heads to spin straight off, we've got a lot of work to do before teleporting humans is feasible. Did you know that there's a ton of atoms in the human body? Okay, yeah, you knew that, of course, but do you know how many? There are around 7 billion billion of them. Because when we start talking about numbers that big, even scientists sound like kindergartners. In Abduction, we can buy that aliens have this incredibly powerful and complicated technology because they're aliens, and aliens can be as scientifically advanced as the story demands. In the real world, keeping track of 7 billion 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 atoms, copying them, moving them over vast distances, it's just not feasible. Some even argue that quantum teleportation and the sort you see in Abduction, or even more popularly, in Star Trek, shouldn't even be considered the same thing. In the latter, you're deconstructing and transporting matter over distances and reassembling it perfectly. In the former, you're merely copying the state of one quantum particle to another. Maybe we'll get there someday. In the meantime, I'll continue fantasizing about teleporting to a strange new world, or at least dematerializing out of my car when I'm stuck in traffic. I hate you, LA! Hey, thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe and share this video with your friends if you dig what we do. If you have ideas for topics to cover, leave them in the comments below, and don't forget to keep on playing.